Hello and welcome to today's video tutorial on mastering VLOOKUP in Excel. In this video, we'll cover everything you need to know about using VLOOKUP, a powerful function that can help you find and retrieve data in Excel spreadsheets. Now, I know some of you might think that VLOOKUP is an old formula, which is true since it has been around since the 80s. And now there are better ways to perform a lookup like index match and XLOOKUP. But VLOOKUP is still widely used and it's still considered sort of first step to understand XLOOKUP or index match. So let's dive right in. For your convenience and following the tradition of this channel, this video is divided into four parts. Part 1 is understanding VLOOKUP. Part 2 is using VLOOKUP. Part 3 are the limitations of VLOOKUP. And part 4 is common errors and their resolution. Before we start, let's quickly understand what VLOOKUP does. VLOOKUP stands for vertical lookup. It is used to search for a specific value in the leftmost column of a table and then retrieve a corresponding value from a column to its right. It's a handy tool for tasks like searching for product information, matching customer names, or locating sales figures. The basic syntax of VLOOKUP is VLOOKUP within brackets, lookup value, comma, table array, comma, column index number, comma, range lookup. The lookup value is the value you want to search for. The table array is the range of cells that contain your data. The column index number specifies the column number in the table from which you want to retrieve the data. Lastly, the optional range lookup argument, when set to false or zero, performs an exact match. If omitted or set to true or one, it performs an approximate match. Let's illustrate this with an example. Suppose you have a product list. Which has its product codes, their weight, the location they are stored, and their quantity. But in his wisdom, whoever made this sheet didn't mention the cost of each product. They decided to mention the cost in a different sheet or even a different file. And we need to get the cost price of our products. One way to do it is that you kind of eyeball it, meaning you look for a product name, in this case, this one, go to the sheet or file with the prices and look for the product code, and there it is. You copy the corresponding price and paste it in your sheet. But for obvious reasons, this won't be the efficient way to do things. What if the product codes are longer, like 15 or 20 digits? What if there are dozens of products, maybe hundreds? That's where a lookup function like VLOOKUP can come in handy. Let's apply VLOOKUP in this case. First, select the cell where you want the result to appear. In this case, we'll put a formula here. Now, type the VLOOKUP formula and enter the necessary arguments. For instance, is equal to VLOOKUP, then press tab. Using the keyboard or the mouse, select the lookup value. In this case, our product name is A2, comma, our table array, which is on another sheet, but remember it can be on another file. So we go to our sheet and select where our product code is. All the way to the column where our prices are mentioned, in this case, column E. Let's take a pause, and at this point, let me give you a bonus tip. Instead of selecting just the table, select the whole column till the end using Control and Space Bar, like this. I'll explain the reason for this in our third part where we discuss the limitations of VLOOKUP. Now back to our formula. For column index number, we need to know how many cells are between a product code and price. So we start from the product code and select till price, which is in this case 5, including the product name and price columns. We need the exact results, so we will use false argument, which can also be written as 0. Close the brackets and press enter. And there we have the price. Notice VLOOKUP has bought the number from the cell but not the dollar sign. That is because in our sheet here, this cell is not formatted as a currency but a general cell. So you may want to change it to your desired format later on. Now let's copy a formula to all the remaining cells and complete our task. You may have not understood the full implication of VLOOKUP with my rather small example. But believe me, in businesses where Excel is used as the main application to keep data, VLOOKUP can easily be in the list of top 5 most used formulas. VLOOKUP can definitely help you find some data that you are looking for, which is buried deep in a cell amongst hundreds of cells. However, as the old saying, nothing is perfect. VLOOKUP is also not perfect. It has some limitations that you should be aware of. Limitation number 1. VLOOKUP can only look up values from left to right. This means that the column containing the value you look up should always be located to the left of the column containing the return value. In our example, if you see, our product names are left of the price column and we are moving from left to right. Limitation number 2. VLOOKUP only returns the first match it finds. This is a big one, and you need to be really careful of the data that you are working on, that your lookup value is unique. Let's figure this out with the same data. Let's say for some reason the same product code is also supplied by another supplier which has a different price. Let's copy a product name and paste it at the end. Let's say supplier is ABC Electricals. Lead time is 5 days, weight is the same, and even the transporter is also the same. But the price is $235. Let's see what happens now when we use our VLOOKUP. So we go back to our sheet and apply the formula again. And we still see the first price. Even if there are many possible matches, VLOOKUP will only return the first one it finds. Limitation number 3. VLOOKUP is case insensitive. This means that it treats uppercase and lowercase letters as equal. In our current example, all the letters are in uppercase. But even if they were in lowercase, VLOOKUP will still consider it the same. This could be both helpful and problematic for you depending on your data. Helpful if your lookup value is all unique, doesn't matter lower or uppercase, but it's unique. You will always get the result you want. But let's say in our last example, someone thought that since the same product name is supplied by another supplier, let's mention it in lowercase to distinguish it from the original product. That's when problem with your lookup comes up. Limitation number 4. VLOOKUP sometimes throws errors if data is not sorted. Some people will say that lookup value in both our sheets should be in the same order or VLOOKUP won't work or give you a hash NA error. Let's try to recreate this. Let's go back to our original sheet and write the same formula again. Before that, let me show you that the respective prices of our product codes are the same as in our original sheet. Let's check in A4, our product code is DTHBV9, which is priced at $1,601. And now let's go to our prices sheet and look for our product. Now over here, our product is in A5 and price is the same, $1,601. Let's take another example. We'll take this product code, which is in this cell and priced at a certain amount, and it's present in our sheet but in a different cell. Now let's use the formula in our main sheet. As you can see, these cells here have returned a hash NA error as if these product codes are not present, but they are. Let me show you. This product code is mentioned here. So how is it possible? Remember when I was explaining the formula and we were selecting the table? I gave you a tip, and instead of selecting just the table, I said to select all the columns to the end. Let's try that tip here. Let's change our formula to select not just the table, but the full columns. Let's delete this formula and write a new formula. Only change will be that we shall select columns till the end using Control and Spacebar shortcut. And now let's copy a new formula to the end, and there you see the hash NA error is gone. And lastly, limitation number 5. VLOOKUP will not work if your table array is changed. If your lookup array, that is the table where the price is mentioned in our case, is changed, maybe someone added an extra column or deleted a column, your VLOOKUP formula will return incorrect values or an error. Let me show you. Say we added an extra column just before price column. Maybe we have to mention last date of procurement. The moment I add a column, all our results in our sheet with VLOOKUP will turn to zero. Because now column index number, which we mentioned as 5, doesn't correspond to the price column we selected in the first place. Now let's see what happens when we remove a column. Let me bring the table back to its original form. Now let's delete a column. Maybe we don't need lead time and we are going to delete it. And our main sheet has the most common error people get while using VLOOKUP, the hash ref error. Don't worry, I'll explain the reason of this error and how you can solve this error in the next part, common errors and their resolution. Now that we have covered VLOOKUP extensively and you feel confident to use it, time and again mistakes will be made and VLOOKUP will give you some errors. Let's discuss those so you know how to avoid them, and if they do come across, how can you resolve them? Here are some of the most common ones. Hash NA. This error occurs when the lookup value is not found in the table. So if you're looking for something that is not there, VLOOKUP will return hash NA error. Let me show you here. We have our VLOOKUP formula results, all fine, no errors, and the moment I change the product name slightly, like change just a letter or number, for VLOOKUP and Excel, it's a whole new lookup value, and if it is not present in our table array, it will return this error. As I had explained earlier, if you have checked that the exact product code that you're looking for does exist in our table and still we are getting this error, use Control and Spacebar to select full columns and you might be able to resolve this. Hash value. Hash value error comes up mainly by two reasons. First is if your lookup value, which is our product code, is greater than 255 characters. Second, if a column index number is less than 1. Let me show you. If we change our column index number to 0, it will return hash value error. But this error is pretty easy to solve. You just have to check your formula and correct the mistake. Hash name. This error is not related to VLOOKUP exclusively, but comes up whenever you mistype your Excel formula or there is an incorrect syntax. So whenever you come across this error while using VLOOKUP or any other formula for that matter, just go back and check that you have used the correct syntax. Hash ref. This is the big one. When I was new to VLOOKUP, I can't tell you how much time I have spent trying to resolve this error. This error comes up when the column index number is greater than the number of columns in the table. Allow me to show you. We know our table array has 6 columns. If we change a column index number in our VLOOKUP formula like this, it will give us a ref error. Because in the previous step in this formula, the table array, we have told VLOOKUP to look up to here, but our new value says different and this is not acceptable to VLOOKUP. To avoid these errors, make sure that you follow the syntax and rules of VLOOKUP diligently. And one practice that I follow is once I'm satisfied with my results, I copy the whole column and paste them at the same place in values. This makes them independent of any changes that may occur in future to our lookup array. But by doing so, we also lose the ability to get updated data. So this is more likely a case-to-case basis, whether you would want to do it or not, totally up to you. That concludes our VLOOKUP video. You've now learned the fundamentals of VLOOKUP in Excel. With this powerful function, you can easily find and retrieve data in your spreadsheets, saving you time and effort. Remember to practice and explore further to become proficient with VLOOKUP. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more Excel tutorials. Stay tuned for more useful tutorials, like our videos, share and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Thank you for watching.